Yeah, good afternoon. Thank you, Amanda, and thanks to the SSF for this opportunity to present. It's a great honor to speak about our company and the future of mobility in front of this audience, and of course, in particular, after such a high-profile keynote speaker. Bestmile was started about 7 years ago to build the world's first fleet orchestration platform for autonomous vehicles. You might ask, why do autonomous vehicles actually need orchestration, in particular if they are called autonomous? Well, autonomous vehicles are self-aware, they can drive themselves, but they are not able to work together as a fleet in order to provide actual mobility services. In other words, they need to be told when to drive where and on which route. Of course, autonomous vehicles present a technology that is a great opportunity, especially because they're electric, but even more so when they are shared, and that enables completely new types of mobility services. In other words, they can reshape mobility, and these changes can come very fast. Technology changes have historically led to inflection points, not very frequently, but when they happen relatively fast, in a matter of a few years, and we see here an example how this played out in the field of transportation about 100 years ago, when the change from horse carriages to automobiles was happening in a matter of a few years. So the question is, how will the future of our transportation look like when autonomous vehicles are introduced on a large scale? To illustrate what is at stake, let's look at the sustainability aspect, so the resource efficiency of car transportation. And let me show you how this changes by the way vehicles or cars are actually operated. So the reference point is, of course, a private car, which essentially transport 1 kilometer of transportation of a person kilometer per kilometer of vehicle distance driven. If we move over to taxis, we see that efficiency drops. Typically, taxis operate at about 60% efficiency. The rest is deadheading to go pick up passengers. The new peer-to-peer ride-hailing services, you all know them and probably use them, are even much less efficient. Recent studies have shown that they spend about only 25% of the entire vehicle kilometers driven on the road to deliver actual transportation services. That is a major reason for the congestion and, of course, a major waste of resources. So the only way to get efficiencies significantly above one is to optimally orchestrate fleets and to allow vehicles on a large scale to be operated more efficiently, do less deadheading, ideally none, and transport more people, more passengers kilometers per each vehicle kilometer invested. And that is exactly what our platform is doing. It essentially acts as a control tower, an automatic control tower for vehicles, telling each vehicle where to go, when, at every moment in time. This way, we enable smart mobility services, which can reach the convenience and flexibility of private motorized transportation, so the private car, while being at the same time much more resource efficient, both regarding the number of assets used, as well as the actual kilometers driven and the energy consumed. As a company, Bestmile was incorporated in 2014 and has grown to over 60 employees by now. We have the headquarters in Lausanne and have presence in major transportation, technology, and innovation hotspots around the world. A large part of our investors come from the transportation industry at large, which is important as we are jointly shaping the future of transportation. And of course, to stay focused on and committed to the problem we are actually set out to solve. And because the future of transportation is still uncertain, Our product is built in a way to address different market participants in fact a very heterogeneous market of potential buyers. At the same time, we need to be able to enable different kinds of mobility services. They go under different names from ride-hailing, microtransit, you might have heard, autonomous shuttles, robotaxis. They all have slightly different shapes, different constraints, and different objectives to fulfill. Also, and perhaps unfortunately, there's no unique and linear path to the future of large on-demand robotaxi fleets. For this reason, we proceed in two dimensions. On one hand, in the autonomous direction, there are the autonomous shuttles, the current generation of autonomous shuttles, which mostly drive at low speeds on a fixed route according to a fixed timetable. So far away from the vision of fully on-demand, highly flexible large fleets. In the other direction, we have professional on-demand services that are still human-driven. Although they are human-driven, they are already able to provide some of the advantages that we hope to get out of the on-demand, flexible new transportation systems. So on the shuttle side, we are involved in several autonomous vehicle projects, most of the ones that are running in Switzerland, a couple of ones in Europe. And on the human-driven side, one of our clients is Alto, a professional on-demand door-to-door ride-hailing service, essentially a competitor to Uber and Lyft, but essentially the antithesis of the asset-free model. They have employed drivers, they own the vehicles or lease them, so they are asset-heavy. But on the incentive side, it means they have an incentive to use their resources as efficiently as possible. And that, I believe, is key to get to an efficient, resource-efficient future transportation system. These are all stepping stones into the future of mobility, where optimized fleets of autonomous vehicles solve our traffic problems in terms of congestion and pollution, and which is also the reason why we received recently the 2019 Global Clean Tech Award. But to be sure, autonomous fleets are not there to replace public transportation. They are to replace private individual transport with a much more efficient system without, and this is very important, without sacrificing the convenience and flexibilities that private transportation gives us today, and also by integrating well with mass transit, which is already very resource efficient. That's what we are doing at Best Mile. Thank you for your attention.